Okay, the fourth thing is going to be, and I'm going to use the players on this, moving without the basketball. This is really important. This is not, these are not plays. Sometimes my players, we drill it so much, they think that these are plays. These are rules of our offense that at any time you're going to move without the basketball. But again, you can't just keep yelling at kids to move without the ball, move without the ball. You have to show them where and how to move. So we teach them concepts offensively, moving without the ball, where we say no matter what offense we're in, no matter what, where we are in the offense, when anytime somebody does this, this is what you do. This, again, is not a play. Okay? So when you move without the ball, one of the first things we teach is, and I think a lot of you do this, but unique, it might be a little unique to us, that's why I wanted to show it, is drive baseline drift to the corner. So if the ball comes to the wing, we're posting up at the block, right? And if we, in any offense, no matter where, when, or how, if we drive to the baseline, we want to hold our seal here. Now, again, you got to read the defense. If the defense is here, are we going to drive baseline? No, now we would try to drive middle. Moving without the basketball would be different. But we teach, hold your seal high side, and 90% of the teams in the SEC will guard us high side. You're going to U-me out and hold seal. You're going to beat your defender. When that happens, you'll drift to the corner. Okay, when obviously the key to this is you got to drive to the basket to score, not drive to the baseline. So if I come over and help, you have to change speeds, hesitate, keep your dribble. Right? This is where a lot of girls will have their head down, all one speed and charge. So you want to slow down at the early help because you couldn't get to the rim. Okay, now you want to take a dribble past the defender and kick corner. While that is happening, what I don't think a lot of other people do that we do is we dive this player. And again, this player can be anybody. It can be a post, can be a guard, whoever ends up in this 4-out-1 at any time in an offense when there's a baseline drop. So we dive the post player to the front of the rim. So now, if you've beaten your player and you've sealed your player and you're rising, the weak side defender has to make a choice. They either have to guard the drift, or when you go to the middle of the basket and you're attacking here with the ball, there's a 2-on-1 right here.